In this video, I'm going to test a couple of end mills from the German company Datron. The tools should perform really well in aluminium, and I'm going to find out if they are a good match with my machine. When you are a long-time viewer of this channel, you have probably seen the progress I've made with milling aluminium. In the first video, I broke a lot of tools. The machine made some terrifying noises and the result wasn't great. The bottle openers from the second video came out okay, but there was a lot of room for improvement for the surface finish. In the third video, I got some good results. I got the surface finish finally to the level that I was searching for. What you didn't saw in the previous videos was how much time all the cuts took. In my opinion, there's a lot of room to improve these times. Maybe you've noticed that I exclusively used the adaptive strategy for my roughing operations. The adaptive strategy only uses tool pads in a radius shape instead of the right line tool pads from a 2D pocket strategy. Because of the radius movements, the tool never makes a complete stop in a corner of a workpiece, where the chance of breaking a tool is high. If your machine has the rigidity, the adaptive strategy can be very efficient. It's easily possible to use the entire length of the tool and make a cut with 20% of the tool's diameter as stepover. Unfortunately, my machine can only handle a 5% stepover. And because of this small stepover, the adaptive strategy might not be the best option for my setup. The alternative is the pocket strategy. With the adaptive strategy, you try to take a deep cut with a small stepover. With the pocket strategy, I'm going to take a shallow cut with a large stepover. A benefit of making a shallow cut is that there are much less cutting forces on the tool, and that reduces the flexing of the X-axis rail. The first Datron tool that we're going to test is this 5mm single flute balance end mill. The first cutting sounds are promising. I can hear a much cleaner sound than the cheaper end mills I've tested. Next up, I tried this design with an experimental axial surface finish. Instead of using the full diameter of the tool, I lowered the stepover to 0.1mm just to see what would happen. Yeah. I think the tool performed really well. There were some small mistakes in the G-code, causing the tool to make some jittery movements in some parts of the program, but besides that, it all worked out. I like how these single flute end mills can just plunge in the material without any problems. The experimental surface finish of this operation wasn't a great success. The surface felt smooth, but the look wasn't great. For the next test, I designed a small wheel that's going to replace the wing nuts of my CNC 6040 fixturing. The first operation is going to cut out the shape, and the second operation is to make a chamfer on the top edge of the wheel. The wheels are going to be cut out of this 24mm hexagon bar of 2011 aluminium. With the lathe, I'm going to turn the stock material to a length of 12mm. And 3/4 of the material is going to be turned to about 23mm round. I'm going to make an M6 screw thread in the wheels, so that I can use them with the M6 bolts to fit in my machine bed. The reason I made the stock material partly round is that the hexagon shape fits perfectly in my machine clamp. And because the machine clamp is not zeroed in, the round shape of the stock material makes it easier to zero it in with an edge finder. First I'm going to make one wheel with a cheap end mill from a previous video, so we have something to compare the expensive end mills with. The result isn't bad, but the radial surface finish is far from shiny.
Yeah.
The surface finish on this workpiece is much better and I'm happy with the result. The next step is to take away the last bit of stock material and the wheels are finished. I'm using a piece of aluminium bar and a bolt to clamp the workpiece in the lathe chuck.